banyak bermunculan usaha rintisan atau yang biasa dikenal dengan startup. Startup juga berkembang pesat di bidang aquaculture. Hal ini dapat menjembatani para pemangku kepentingan aquaculture. Usaha ini sangat didukung oleh pemerintah karena dapat mendukung konektivitas rantai bisnis aquaculture. Dalam hal akses pasar, startup juga dapat menjamin efisiensi rantai pasar dan juga meningkatkan efisiensi waktu, tenaga, dan proses dalam kegiatan on-farm. Dengan adanya inovasi digital ini, menyebabkan beberapa isu pergeseran aquaculture, seperti optimalisasi pemanfaatan potensi lahan budidaya berbasis daya dukung lingkungan, membaur rantai produksi dari hulu ke hilir, dan integrasi kegiatan dengan anggaran antara para stakeholder. Nah, berbicara tentang startup, apa aja sih contoh startup di aquaculture yang saat ini telah berkembang di Indonesia? Berikut beberapa contoh startup aquaculture yang telah berkembang di Indonesia. Yang pertama ada e-fishery. E-fishery mengembangkan teknologi pintar pemberian pakan. Lalu ada fishbuy yang berfungsi untuk menggalang dana yang akan disalurkan ke para pembudidaya. Yang ketiga ada jala. Jala menawarkan sistem manajemen berbasis data di tambak. Akan tetapi, spesial untuk teman-teman semua, kali ini kita telah mengundang CEO startup dari luar negeri, yaitu Startup Hatch dari Singapura. Penasaran kan apa aja yang bakal kita obrolin kali ini? Yuk ikutin keseruannya.
By the way, Mr. Murphy, how did Hatch come from? Why is called Hatch?
Well, I'll start with the second question. Hatch is something that, you know, opens up, right? It starts to grow. And I guess that's what we try to do with companies around the world involved in aquaculture. We want to hatch their potential. We want to help them grow. We joined together, myself and my co-founders, back in 2017 with a view to starting the world's first aquaculture accelerator program. Up to that point in time, investment in aquaculture was typically a venture play where you find a company, you do your due diligence, and then you invest in that company and take an equity stake. But we wanted to do it in a different way, by trying to add value to those companies, bringing in experts to help accelerate that growth even more. And in 2018, we launched the world's first aquaculture accelerator in Norway. We followed that up with another program in Ireland later that year. And then we branched out into, we opened up location hubs in Hawaii and Singapore. So we brought our companies, our accelerator companies, to all those three locations with a view to exposing them to different types of aquaculture practices, species, but brought them on farms across the world so they can learn and understand the challenges of producing sustainable seafood.
Okay, this is so interesting. It's awesome, Mr. Murphy. So, what fun thing do you remember the most while being a mentor at an event?
It's a really good question. I've been involved in startups for many, many years. What never ceases to surprise me is the amazing amount of ideas that people have out there. When you think that you can't innovate any further or there can't be any better ideas, we're always blown away by the kind of ideas that people have. And interestingly for me also, many of these ideas in aquaculture, and this is a message I want to get across to your student body, is that nearly 50 to 60% of all our programs and companies we invest in, the founders actually have no background in aquaculture whatsoever. They're engineers, they're geneticists, they're data analysts, they're computer scientists, they're a whole range of different backgrounds, but they have a skill set that has, an opportunity to solve a problem in aquaculture. So, you know, dealing with people who have no idea of aquaculture, but, you know, they want to learn about it with a view to bringing their idea and technology to the sector is always a very interesting and rewarding effort for me in terms of helping guide these people to make the best of their background and also their innovation.
It's so many benefits. So everyone have same opportunity to be aquaculture startup, right?
Yeah, for sure. If you have, you know, as I say, you know, 50% of our people that we engage with have no background in aquaculture, and that's okay.
Okay, As we know, Hatch is a startup. In your opinion, what is startup?
That's a very good question. I guess a good definition maybe is that it's a company that's in its very first stage of operations. Usually it's, they have no money, but they have an idea that they want to commercialize. It's initially or getting to a stage where maybe they develop some revenue, that they find a customer that, you know, sees a value in their technology and wants them to scale, maybe take on some investors who take a share in their company. But typically flexible, very fast-paced company, early stage company that is looking to develop an idea. And again, it's a really tough place to be. It's a tough job, but those that succeed, as many will know, you know, can do amazingly well and, you know, make a lot of money, but also have the right impact in terms of bringing, you know, their innovations to, you know, challenges and solving problems out there. So it's a wonderful entity for me, and we've been investing in startups for quite some time.
Okay. Hatch is aquaculture startup, right? So what is startup in aquaculture, Mr. Murphy?
I guess it's any early stage company that is looking at aquaculture. It's, I guess, looking at all the challenges that exist in producing food, seafood. And as I said, you know, those innovations can come from a variety of different areas. They can be to do with alternative feed, better feed, you know, looking after the animals and giving them, you know, better vaccines. Looking at, you know, ways of monitoring the fish and their health. It can be a range of different technologies, but all focusing on ultimately on producing seafood more sustainably. And that's one message I want to get across to you, is that Hatch does not invest in any company that doesn't add to the sustainability sustainable production of seafood. You know, it's really critical that it has to be sustainable and doesn't have a negative impact on the environment.
Okay. In your opinion, how is the current development of aquaculture startup?
The current involvement? We currently track about 1,500 startups in our space, all providing various different types of technology and innovations. In terms of them engaging with the industry, I guess being part of an accelerator like ours can certainly give them a platform to grow their business and connect with the right kind of people. I think typically startups in the aquaculture space don't do a great job of, you know, getting themselves out there. They don't focus on the right things in terms of bringing and adding value to their business every day. I think they're not great at commercializing or marketing their business. So I guess that's where entities like Hatch can really help that. They can introduce them to the right kind of people and they can get them to focus on the right things. And very often, the failure that most startups fail is because they try to make something that they think people want and not what their customers actually need. I don't think they talk to customers enough. They don't really get close to their potential market enough to really understand the challenges that they face. And ultimately, in my experience, that's why most startups fail, is because they, as I say, they make things that they think they want as opposed to what they actually want. And they waste a lot of time and investment in that. And, you know, for me, a startup's most valuable asset is its time. They don't have time to be making mistakes, so they need to get it right first time. I guess that's where an entity like Hatch can really help those companies, because we can help them focus on the right things.
Okay, sounds good, Mr. Murphy. With the AIC event at Aquafest 2021, what is your hope that this event can provide many benefits for aquaculture lover?
I really do believe that events like this are critically important to the aquaculture industry. We need to find more young guys and girls and innovators and smart you know, academics and researchers and entrepreneurs to attract into our industry, which, as I say, is quite niche, but it is the fastest growing sector in the world. And if you are looking for an opportunity and looking for a sector where there is a ton of opportunity, I can genuinely promise you, you know, and my colleague Dylan will tell you also, you know, what's going on in various different parts of the world. There's amazing opportunity. And aquaculture will help you travel. It's a global industry with a ton of potential. There's a lot of investors coming into the space, which is always great. There's a lot of IP being registered. So there's a lot of ideas being generated. And aquaculture needs a lot of help and it needs a lot of intervention in terms of technology.
The next question is, what kind of innovation is expected from HAIC participants?
Good question. The answer to which I don't know. We're hoping to have, you know, as I said at the very outset of this conversation, what all never ceases to amaze me is the range of ideas and technologies and innovations that people come up with. I think what I would like to see is them looking to solve a significant problem in aquaculture, be it looking at alternative feed, looking at disease management, maybe looking at depending on the species, but you know, anything that, you know, is looking to make a contribution to producing seafood more sustainably. And I think I've said that word many, many times in this interview, and it's important that, we get that across. It is critical that we are able to do that, to produce the amount of food that we need for the growing population. Because by 2050, we're going to need to produce, I think it's 3 times more food than we do today. And there is a real challenge producing that on land. So aquaculture has a really critical part to play in our global food system. So, you know, for those who are looking to join the event, think big, you know, look at the big problems out there, use your background, your intelligence, and your maybe some research with a view to looking at, you know, ways that you can help solve the challenge that exists in this sector. So it'd be awesome just to see the kind of the range of applications. And Dylan, my colleague here, does a great job in digging deeper into those kind of ideas with a view to seeing what commercial value they would have in the sector also, because, you know, all that good work and research and time that startups put into developing these ideas, you need to have a market for it and you need to have a customer paying for it. So, you know, we're looking forward to helping some of those ideas get a bit more focus maybe, and maybe even, you know, look at, you know, connect them with our network and potentially invest in them in the future. So, you know, there's all sorts of wonderful opportunity here. And in connecting with Hatch and our network, I think we can give a really true and honest piece of feedback to those joining your event in terms of the quality of their idea.
Okay. As we know, this year Hatch has joined as one of the mentors at IEC 2021. Can you share your impression and how you feel as an IEC mentor?
As I said earlier, Indy, I'm really excited to, you know, engage with young, bright innovators. You know, we will do everything that we can possibly to help shape their idea. It takes a lot to build a successful. The message I want to get across is, okay, this is a real world with real problems. And, you know, we would like these guys and girls not just to look at this as a piece of research. Why not actually build a business? Why not, you know, find a way to, you know, really make a commercial success of this idea? You know, a lot of researchers out there globally, you know, their biggest ambition is to publish their research, which is fine. But we'd be more interested in seeing how that research can be commercialized and have a positive benefit for the world of aquaculture. So don't look at this as just a simple university project. You know, we're really serious about engaging with your students. We're really serious and committed to helping them shape some of their ideas, if that's the case. Because we would love to see some really exciting projects kicking out of this that we can help and support over the months and years to come.
Okay, because the time is limited. I think that's all for today, Mr. Murphy and Mr. Howell. Come on, guys, let's participate in ICE activities at Aquafest 2021. This event will be very, very cool because one of the mentors of this activity is directly from H. So save the date and don't miss it, okay? Okay, guys, maybe that's all we talk on today. Thank you very much, Mr. Murphy and Mr. Howell, for being right here and sharing knowledge with us. We formed the Aquafest 2021 team and also with H. Say goodbye. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
See you soon.
See you
all soon.
Bye-bye. Mr. Murphy and Mr. Howell.